The sea is full of water. Do you know how the undersea tunnel is built? After watching it, I have to admire the wisdom of the engineers. For a long time, human beings have never stopped exploring the ocean. Nowadays, although human beings have not completely conquered the vast ocean, they have made many achievements. For example, the subsea tunnel project shared with you in this video. The subsea tunnel itself is located in the sea, so how was it built? In fact, there are many construction methods for constructing undersea tunnels, and one of our common methods is the pipe sinking method. The immersed pipe method is to sink the pipes made on land to the designated position on the seabed, and then splice them. This is not just a single section of pipe that can be completed, but to put together the required pipes, section by section. The most important thing to pay attention to in this method is the connection between the splicing pipe and the pipe, because if it is not handled properly, there will be water leakage. Therefore, before conducting pipeline sinking operations, both ends of the pipeline must be sealed, and after splicing, the seal must be removed, thus forming an integral tunnel pipeline. After the pipeline is sunk to the seabed, it will be covered with gravel above and outside the pipeline to prevent the pipeline from floating and ensure the safety of the tunnel. When China built the Hong Kong-Zhuhai-Macau Bridge, a 6.7-kilometer long tunnel passed through the seabed, and this tunnel is also the longest immersed tube submarine tunnel in the world. The construction of this tunnel uses the method of pipe sinking. However, this method is only applicable to seabed environments where the riverbed is stable and the flow is relatively gentle. If it is in a turbulent environment, this method is not suitable for use. Another method is the tunneling method, which mainly relies on the shield machines we commonly use on the ground to carry out operations. A shield machine customized according to the diameter of the tunnel is used to excavate in the soft soil layer on the seabed. During the operation process, muck can be transported while excavating, and reinforcement can also be carried out while construction is in progress. After the shield machine has excavated the undersea tunnel, the next work is to strengthen the overall tunnel and carry out special treatment for waterproofing and collapse prevention of the tunnel layer. Of course, the role of a shield machine is not just excavation. When the machine digs forward, it will use prefabricated curved concrete blocks to support the tunnel wall. Therefore, a shield machine is a machine that can simultaneously achieve excavation and stacked construction. If there is any drawback to it, it should be its speed. Generally, shield machines can only dig tunnels a few meters deep every day. Although the shield machine is powerful, it cannot work in some extreme environments. As the shield machine moves forward, the rock beneath the ground gradually becomes hard. At this point, it is necessary to withdraw the shield machine and continue construction using traditional mining methods. The traditional mining method is to excavate a small piece of the tunnel first, then provide support, and then continue to expand the cross-sectional area of the tunnel, and then provide support for the expanded area, to build it step by step. Some people may be worried that in the deep seabed, tunnel facilities are always under pressure and the endless impact of ocean waves. What if there is a seawater leakage and infiltration? In fact, in subsea tunnels, engineers will bury and install many monitors, and one will be installed every other distance. The collector will work every second and monitor the situation in the tunnel. Judging the safety of a tunnel based on very complex parameters such as soil, rock, and air humidity in the tunnel can provide early warning of areas and sections requiring maintenance promptly, ensuring the smoothness and safety of the subsea tunnel. Therefore, the successful construction of the undersea tunnel is one of the greatest advances in human transportation.